These are Kaisercraft's wood flourishes. They're made from super thin plywood and are available in a huge assortment of shapes. As they come from the package, they're unfinished wood, and I've used them like this, and they're really nice. But what's even more fun is to add color and design to make the flourishes coordinate with your projects. There are a lot of things that you can do to embellish them, and I'm going to share some of those techniques with you today. So let's get started. I'm going to start with the first method, which is just any kind of acrylic paint. Now I have a heart and I have Lumiere Halo Pink Gold because I like this color a lot. So I'm just going to brush it on there. Now this flourish has little openings cut in it. If you find that the paint gets down in there, afterwards just go in with a toothpick and you can kind of pick it out of there, or you can even go in before it all dries up. And you can see that these are nice and smooth as they come from the package. They don't require any sanding or anything. Now again, because this is unfinished wood, the first application of paint might raise the grain a little bit. I don't find that it does, but depending on what paint you use, it may. If you find that you don't like the opacity of the color, if you see the grain of the wood through your paint, let this dry and come back and apply another coat. Now, this flourish has openings in it, and I can already see that I've got a little bit of paint stuck in here. So what I'm going to do is come in with a toothpick and just clean them out and make certain that I don't have the paint blobbed in there. Put this to one side, let it dry, and then this is ready to do something else with. Now, our second technique for adding color to a bare flourish is I'm going to use Ranger's Distress Stains. I like these a lot. They come in a wide assortment of colors and they go on really easily. I have four different colors here, and I'm going to start with sort of the lightest of them, and I'm just going to come in here and dab color on. Now this is kind of messy, but it's fun, and you can really kind of play around and mix your colors on here as you go along. These colors will change a little bit as the paint absorbs into, or the stain I should say, absorbs into the wood, but they will, as long as you don't start with a really pale color, they'll remain fairly true. If you decide that it's too light when you're through, just come back with your dabbers, you know, your distress stains, and go ahead and add some more color. So there's our second method for adding color. Our third method is even faster. I have one of Ranger's color wash sprays here. This happens to be lettuce, and I have a flourish. All I'm going to do is spritz the color on here. Now let me just pick this up so that I'm not working in this puddle. You can do one of two things. Either leave this to let it dry, or if you think that the color is a little too dark, come in here and dab it. And if you decide, okay, that made it a little bit lighter than what I want, come back, add another coat, and let it dry. The nice thing about this is that you're not limited to a single coat. If you need two coats of paint, go ahead and do it. If you need multiple coats of the stains or the color wash sprays, go ahead and do it. Once you have color on your flourish, now comes the fun part. How can we add design and texture and other good things to it? And that's what I'm going to show you next. Here's the heart that we just worked on. The distress stain is dry now, and so as I look at this, I think, well, maybe it would be cool if I had pink all the way around the edge, or I wanted to add color however. What I'm going to do, I have Ranger's Distress Ink. This is aged mahogany and one of their ink essential blending tools. I'm going to ink up this tool, and then I'm just going to come in and I'm going to pretend this is a tag or a piece of paper, and I'm just going to blend the aged mahogany distress stain around the edge of this heart. Now having said that, if you wanted to take a flourish that was just out of the package and unfinished, you could certainly color it with distress stain, with distress ink if you want to. You don't have to use the stain or the paint or those other methods that I just showed you. This is a little bit more exact way to get color where you want it, and it will work with any of the colors in the distress line. And there you see, this piece now has that aged mahogany all the way around the edges. Another way that you can add visual interest to a flourish is to rubber stamp on it. Here's the heart that we painted with the Lumiere Halo Pink Gold. I have Stays On Black ink. This is a permanent ink. It's a solvent base and it dries almost immediately. I'm going to use that along with this beeline stamp that's called Passionate. And I'm just going to stamp in the upper corner of this heart. I'm not going to use the whole stamp. I'm just going to pick a piece of it that I like, ink it up, and I'm just going to come in here and stamp the corner. And you see what you get. Now, you can stamp with a flower like I've done, or you could pick something. Now, this is one of the other flourishes, and what you could do if you want, I have this text stamp. I'm going to use my same black stays on, and now I'm just going to come in and I'm going to stamp across this tree, and you'll just see little bits of the text going across the tree, which I think makes a really cool look. Now, as always, I'm going to take still photos of all of these, and you'll be able to see them on the website, but this is a really cool thing. Here's another heart that I did a little earlier, and here's the one that we just did. So there's lots of different things that you can do here when you go ahead and you rubber stamp. Again, bear in mind you want to use a permanent ink like Stazon, and you'll be good to go. Those of you who follow the videos know that I haven't met anything that glimmers that I don't love, and so one of the things that occurred to me was that it would be pretty fun to put some Perfect Pearls mists on one of these. Now, you can either use the pre-made ones that Ranger make, or you can make your own, and we have a video for that, and I will put a link on the page where this video appears so that you can find that. All you need to do, it's very simple, is come in here, and I'm going to mist this pretty heavily. I want to make certain that there's enough of the Perfect Pearls on there so that when it dries you can really see it. And of course you could probably put two coats on there if you wanted, but once it dries you end up with this, and you can see the way that this sparkles and glimmers. And this makes a really nice piece. Use it however you want to, but you have this really cool, colorful, glimmery thing to attach to your project. I like to use a gel pen and come in, and you can doodle on your flourishes. In this case, I'm just going to come in and draw some dots on here, just to add a little bit of interest to this little oval frame. Again, because these are unsealed, unfinished wood, the gel pen is going to soak in a little bit, but all that means is that you might have to go back over your dots a second time if they seem to fade in to, in this case, the green background. So you can just play around, you can doodle, you can, you know, you can draw lines, you can pretty much do whatever you want. This is a fairly narrow piece, so I'm just going to come in and do these little dots on here. I think it makes this frame a little bit more interesting, and then I could put it on a journal page or anything like that. In fact, I have something in mind. I'm working on another journal, and I think I know where I'm going to put this or something that's close to this. So again, very effective, very simple, but it really adds spice to whatever it is that you're working on. The final technique I want to share with you today is how you can use Perfect Pearls powders on your flourishes. I've taken one of these little locks and will tell you that I came in before I started to apply the Perfect Pearls and I spritzed it with diluted color wash spray. I just wanted to lay out a color pattern on there so I kind of knew what I was working with. Now, I've already put one coat of Perfect Pearls on here because I wanted to see what it looked like, and what you get is a fairly light coverage and light shimmer. Now, if you like that, that's great, but if you're like me and you prefer a little bit more depth of color and you want more shimmer, then come back and put a second coat on. And it's as simple as dipping your brush in the powder and patting it in place on the flourish. Now, having done the first coat of this, I can see that the second coat goes on and does provide more depth of color. So unless you want something very pale and very subtle, you're probably going to need to do two coats at a minimum, and if you want something more, you'd have to do a third. And I do have something that I've worked on previously that I'll show you when we get through working on this, and you'll get an idea of what else you can do besides a little lock like this. Now, when you're through with one color, all I do is just run the brush on my finger and I dip it into the second color, and that kind of just shakes out any loose powder. Again, I'm just going to tap this in place. Okay, so there's the second coat done, and because these are perfect pearls, the resin that adheres them to the surface is already in place, and so the way to set this coat is to, and you're not going to see me do this, but I'm going to mist lightly in the air, and then I'm going to swoop this through the mist, and that will be enough to set the perfect pearls. So hold on 1 second while I go to one side and do that. Okay, so I'm set. Now, if this ends up not being quite as dark as what you had in mind, you can come back and add successive coats until you get the depth of color and the depth of shimmer that you want. But as you can see from everything we've done here today, there's a lot of different things that you can do with these flourishes, and they make great embellishments. This is one I mentioned a moment ago. I worked on this, and you can see this little tree. What I did was I put some color on these leaves and some color on the trunk, and then I came back in with the perfect green and touched it up on these leaves, and it did take multiple coats to get this depth of color. As always, there will be still photos of all of these pieces on the website on the page where the video is, so you can see them all. I hope you have a great time working with the flourishes.